We've been talking about how how to enhance our writing based on perspective, theme, voice. So today what we're going to practice is we're going to work on looking at context clues. So we're going to do a short little bell work right now. So looking at the two sentences on the board, what I want you to do, they're also written down on this sheet of paper. I want you to put in the word that you think would fit in the space that is missing. So read the sentence, and then write down the word that you think would fit in the first sentence in order to make it a complete sentence, and what word you think would fit into the second sentence. If you can think of more than one, then go ahead and put more than one. That's fine. So write down words that you think would fit. You know what? Why don't we write at least two words per sentence? So right now what we're doing is looking at context clues in order to determine sentence context. And once again, remember the big ideas that we've been working on is how can we write in order to discover ourselves? So once you have at least two words per sentence, go ahead and put your pencils down. Finish. So Alfredo, give me one of the words that you used to complete number one. Okay. Now read it using the word that you used.
The team was flabbergasted when they won the trophy.
Okay. So Kevin, what word did you use?
Eager.
Eager? Now reread it using your word. Okay. Esmeralda, what did you use?
The team was proud when they won the trophy.
Oh, okay. Giovanna. Oh, I like some extra details there. Screaming with excitement. Okay, so looking at the four words that we used, you can tell me, is there any similarities, any differences? Do you guys see anything? What's your observation of the words that were selected?
Social, emotion, excitement.
Okay, so they're all words that show emotion. Okay, anything else? Anything else? Anything else?
Know where you are.
Anything else? One thing that I noticed is that, Cecilia, just come in and take a seat and then we'll address that. Okay, just take a seat. One thing that I noticed, this person sounds surprised. This person sounds excited to get started. So there's some subtle differences, I think, based on how we interpret it, maybe from our own perspective. Like some of us that are like superstar athletes, we might feel maybe casual when they win the trophy, because they win all the time. They're used to winning. They don't know what it feels not to win, so they're not even excited about games anymore. Let's just say that your team always doesn't win, and all of a sudden you play the number one team. But you just play it like any other game, and you just try your best. And how do you think the people on that team would feel? When you don't expect to win, and you're playing the number one team.
Right.
Surprised. I think before the game, they might be a little bit scared. And then when they win, they're surprised, like Alfredo says. So this has to do, I think, with perspective. Like, I think I would be eager, because some people always want to try their best. But if you always win, I don't even think you value it as much anymore. So I think it depends on perspective. And this kind of shows me that we each have a different perspective. And I like the word choice here, flabbergasted, because what do you think this person feels? That was your word, Alfredo.
He's surprised that they won.
Yeah. Okay, so second sentence. What word did you use down here, Esmeralda?
I said a fight.
They were what?
A fight during the demonstration.
Oh, a fight. Okay. Kevin, what did you use? Okay. Giovanna? Okay.
A lash fight.
A what?
A lash fight. A lash fight. Basically, what it means is basically something was happening and they don't like that, so they do something to it. So, like, if I write it, it's basically like a riot, but if it happens, when you say something.
And how do you spell it?
L-A.
Double A?
No, L-A.
L-A.
S. H. And back.
Okay. Okay. So, why do you think? Because this is a different, this is like a, three of us came up with this. So why do you think we all came up with the same word? Based on some of the things we were just discussing. When we're talking about perspective. Do you think that, what are some context clues that made us think? What do we, how did you figure out what word to use here? What did you look at?
The last part.
Okay, so this is a context clue that is what? Bad. What else? What else could be a context clue? So these are simple, but some of our reading, after we discuss it, right, then we figure it out. But sometimes we have a hard time distinguishing what the context clues are.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what else could have been a context clue?
Something serious.
Something serious? And what word told you it was something serious?
Police.
The police? Okay. Serious, and the police are there. I thought the police are supposed to be our friends. What tells us that in this case it's not like a friendly situation.
Something broke out.
Okay, word choice. Something broke out. Okay. And then anything else? Let's see. if you don't see anything, that's fine, but anything else? Can you an idea? So here, what does demonstration mean?
Presenting.
And what else does it mean? Is it always positive? Sometimes a demonstration can be positive. Sometimes we demonstrate when we're doing what? You're studying civil rights and history. Sometimes we demonstrate when what?
Boycott.
When there's a boycott or something that shows some strong feelings about something. Okay, so a little bit of practice on context clues. So on the bottom of the sheet that we went over this, you're going to see a poem. And in this poem, there's going to be some blank spaces. I want you to fill in the blanks with words that you think finish off the poem. You want a clean sheet. Some of you wrote a little bit bigger. Here, take this poem. Some of these are homework. You can use the space, or you can just use the space that's right here. Now, fill in the blanks with whatever you think word choice would fit. And kind of follow the same model, looking at some words that will give you context clues. Any words that you don't know that are in the sentences and you want to ask for some vocabulary help. These are a little bit more difficult than the two that were up on the board when we first started. So try your best to fill in, looking at context clues, any vocabulary that you might recognize. That might give you clues to any of the words that you're not sure about. Word.